Come on, everybody, let's go.
Ah, this is so exciting. You know, this is the 10th year my father has raced his yacht in the Newport Regatta.
Oh, man, I hope he lets me on his team this year.
We see Stewie at the mailbox as Brian walks up carrying a duffel bag.
Come on, Stewie, let's go.
Yes, I'm just checking the mail. I say, here's one from the vet.
Oh, wait, give me that.
Good Lord, worms? You have worms?
I do not have worms, all right? I just got checked for worms. Oh, wait, no, I do have worms. Oh, God. Oh, what am I going to do? I can't afford the medication for this.
Well, you could ask Lois and the fat one.
No, you cannot tell them about this, please.
You know, perhaps you should worry a little less about your pride and a little more about the creepy crawlies Shawshanking their way out of your balloon knot.
Come on, kids, off to Grandma and Grandpa's house.
Thank God I finally got some time away from the evil monkey in my closet.
We angle on the evil monkey doing his trademark point and stare from Chris's window. As the Griffin's car backs out of the driveway, we stay on the evil monkey, who withdraws in. He sighs, he grabs an album from a nearby shelf and puts an LP on the stereo. He then dons enormous headphones from which we hear Foghat's Slow Ride. He lies back in the bed with his hands behind his head like Mitch from Dazed and Confused. He lies there for a moment, then pulls a box out from under the bed, takes out rolling papers, and starts to roll a joint. At the Peterschmidt's Newport mansion, the Griffin's car pulls out front. Out by the pool, moments later, Carter and Babs Peterschmidt sit poolside. The Griffins enter.
Lois, darling, it's wonderful to see you.
Carter and Babs stand to greet the Griffins.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Daddy.
Grandpa!
Carter hugs Lois, Chris, and Meg.
Hello, everyone.
Peter moves in to hug Carter, arms outstretched.
Hiya, Mr. Peterschmidt.
Peter, I see you're still fatter than holy hell.
You can read me like a book.
A little later, in Lois's old bedroom in the mansion, the Griffins enter. The room is still full of remnants of Lois's teen years.
Isn't this fun, Peter? You and I get to stay in my old high school room.
Wow, this looks just like my room at home.
Yeah, except for all the trophies and pictures of friends.
Stewie notices one of the trophies on Lois's bookcase.
Oh, that's the second most impressive trophy I've ever seen.
In a flashback to an auditorium, Stewie stands at the podium of an awards show.
And the Grammy for Album of the Year goes to Justin Timberlake.
As Justin Timberlake rushes to the stage, Stewie swings the Grammy, nailing him right in the face. Justin goes down.
Ha! It actually goes to Nelly.
Wow. Mom, were you a Miss Teen Rhode Island?
I sure was, Meg, when I was 16 years old. In fact, your mom was offered a modeling contract.
Really? But why didn't you take it?
Yeah, I wanted to, but your grandfather wouldn't let me. But Daddy, they offered me a contract.
My girl is not lowering herself to modeling. That sort of uncouth activity is below this family. Now go away, I'm busy.
That evening at the Newport Barrington Hotel dining room, the Griffins eat with Carter and Babs, angle on Stewie and Brian. Brian takes a bite of food.
Feeding the worms, are you?
Stewie, shut up, all right?
Yes, I imagine those little fellows are enjoying quite a feast.
You know what's interesting? I've only been alive for 6 weeks. I know nothing of the world beyond this dog's stomach, and I still find John Oliver pretentious.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 20th annual Newport Regatta. Newport would like to extend a special welcome to all those here today who have children stationed overseas in Iraq.
Angle on all the rich white people staring blankly.
I'm just kidding.
The rich white people laugh and applaud politely. Angle on Carter's yacht, which is at the edge near the dock. The Griffins, without Peter, and Babs stand on the dock.
There they are, Team Peterschmidt. Say, where's your husband? Or as I call him, my son-in-lard. Snap. Snap.
Oh, I'm sure he'll be along, Daddy.
Ahoy, Mr. Peterschmidt.
Peter, what the hell are you doing in my bathtub?
Oh, this is not a bathtub. This is the SS Peterschmidt kicker.
This is ridiculous. I won't have a member of my family racing in a bathtub.
Well, Daddy, you didn't want Peter in your boat, so Team Griffin is going to give you a run for your money.
And now to fire the starting gun is one of those Karens from the internet.
I'm pronouncing it Karen now, and you should have known that. May I speak to your manager?
He fires the gun. A little bit later on the harbor, the boats begin the race.
Ah, we're not going fast enough.
Griffin's bathtub is suddenly overtaken by Carter's yacht. As Carter passes them, he shouts,
"Loser!"
What did he say?
Carter throws a cell phone into the bathtub. Peter picks it up. It rings. Peter answers it.
"Hello?
I said you're a loser.
Who is this?"
Angle on the finish line, we see the boats approaching from a distance. Angle on the bathtub, which is lagging just behind Carter's yacht.
There's the finish line. We can't let him beat us.
We gotta lose some extra weight. Quick, everyone take off your clothes.
Peter begins to strip and throw his clothes overboard. The family, unsure, follows suit. The bathtub starts to close in on Carter.
It's working.
Just need a little more.
Peter grabs Meg, who, like the rest of the family, is now in her underwear, and hurls her overboard with a splash and a scream.
We love you, honey!
And with that, the Griffins shoot ahead of Carter and cross the finish line, stopping at the dock. The family cheers and gets out of the bathtub, exhilarated. Carter's boat pulls up.
Lois, what the hell were you doing out there?
Not listening to you for once, Daddy. And look what happened. I had a lot of fun. I should have stopped listening to you a long time ago. Let's go home, Peter.
Right behind you. Hey, where's Meg?
On a fishing boat out at sea, Seamus and his crew reel in a net filled with a lot of fish and Meg.
That's what we call a manatee, boys. Or in nautical slang, the sea cow. Damn these worms. Ugh, this itch.
Ryan, what the hell are you doing?
Nothing. I'm just some Pilates.
Don't lie to me, Brian. I know what this is. You're looking for an ass race. First one to the kitchen wins. Go!
Still got the worms, eh?
Yeah, that stupid medicine's $300.
Well, let me make a proposal. I'll front you the money and you pay it off by working for me.
He hands Brian a brochure.
Cash scam? Are you kidding? I don't want anything to do with that pyramid scheme.
Well, very well then. Enjoy your worms.
Wait. What would I have to do?
Just be in my room tomorrow at 9 a.m. for orientation. Until then, keep this in mind. Whether you think you can or you think you can't, you're right. See you tomorrow.
Hey, everybody. Wait till you see this.
Oh, my God. Movable printed type. We must keep this from the serfs, lest they gain literacy and threaten the landed gentry.
What do you got there, my lord?
Nothing. Back to your turnips.
Look, it's a picture of us at the regatta.
Wow, Mom, you look pretty.
Oh, thank you, Chris. I thought so, too. And you know what? I'm going to take that chance my father never let me take when I was younger. I'm going to become a model.
Hey, that's fantastic, Lois. And I'll pleasure myself to your photos.
Me too.
Me too.
Oh, God, Meg, that's sick. That's your mother.
I'm just trying to fit in.
Get out. Get out of this house. I said no! That's good about your modeling, Lois.
And that's the end of that first act from that fourth season episode.